I have this story, and I was involved in a critique group in Austin, Texas. We were all baby writers. We're all published today. And we would load up the car and we would all go together to these conferences and we would share the hotel room and we'd go from place to place. And I had taken the manuscript to a workshop that Kathy Oppelt did in LaGrange, Texas, which is between Austin and Houston. Kathy, notable Newbery Honor author, National Book Award finalist, is my original children's writing teacher, mentor, and bossy big sister. And she had hosted a workshop and invited editors down for that. I had gone to a workshop, I believe it was in Houston, and I had sent a copy of the manuscript to Rosemary Brosnan, who'd expressed interest in a prior manuscript, Indian Shoes. All of a sudden, the editor who'd gone to Kathy's workshop was interested in acquiring the book. An editor at the Houston conference was interested in acquiring the book. And Rosemary was interested in acquiring the book too. And I panicked. I was very concerned. I didn't know what to do. Publishing, like every industry, has its culture and its expectations, its lingo. And I didn't want to offend anyone or burn any bridges. So I reached out to a literary agent. Ginger Dalton at Curtis Brown was my dream agent. I wrote her a note. It was, by today's standards, shockingly unprofessional. It said something, I'm paraphrasing, "Dear Ginger, hi, this is Sin from the All List. I have a question, if you don't mind, and if you do, I'm sorry I bothered you. Bye." Like, it was literally, I was 27 years old. I was very nervous. And she wrote back, she's so lovely. She said, "Dear Sin, of course I know who you are. What is your question?" And I replied, "I have this terrible problem. I wrote this manuscript and I took it to a workshop and a conference and I sent it to an editor," which back then was considered fine. And they all want it and I don't know what to do. And I was wondering what I should do. And I'll never forget this. She said, "Dear Cynthia, having multiple editors interested in one's work is not what we in the industry call a problem." And so we had a lovely conversation wherein I sent her a couple of other things that I was working on. And she has been my agent of record for the entirety of my career, which is unusual in children's publishing, but I'm profoundly grateful. Rosemary acquired the manuscript at Lodestar, which was almost immediately thereafter eliminated in a corporate merger. And then she bought it again at Morrow Jr., which almost immediately thereafter was eliminated in a corporate merger. However, they kept her editorial team on board. And so I have a somewhat unique distinction. I think Monica Brown is in the same situation. So there is more than one of us who sold their first book to one publisher, had it produced at a second, and released at a third. And that was my introduction to the industry. And, you know, real tears were cried along the way. I didn't know if it would all turn out all right, but it has. And, you know, Rosemary and Ginger and I are still working together. It's been where we're at 2021, and Jingle Dancer sold in 1997, 98, toward the end. So yeah, it's been quite a journey.